Penguin Random House Audio presents Vera Wong's Unsolicited Advice for Murderers by Jesse Q. Sutanto. Read for you by Eunice Wong. To Mama, the OG Vera. 1. Vera. Vera Wong Juju, age 60, is a pig, but she really should have been born a rooster. We are, of course, referring to Chinese horoscopes. Vera Wong is a human woman, thank you very much, but roosters have nothing on her. Every morning at exactly 4:30, Vera's eyelids snap open like roller shades shooting up. Then the upper half of her body levitates from the mattress, no lazy rolling out of bed for Vera, though admittedly sitting up in bed now comes with about half a dozen clicks and clacks of her joints. She swings her fuzzy socked feet out with gusto and immediately finds the slippers she placed next to her bed with military precision the night before. She takes a quick moment to send a text to her son, reminding him that he's sleeping his life away and should have been up and at it before her. He is, after all, a young man with a whole world to conquer. Late mornings, Vera believes, are only for toddlers and Europeans. After a quick wash, Vera dons her morning gear, a polo shirt with a Ralph Lauren logo so big that it covers her entire left breast. Well, okay, thanks to the ravages of time and gravity, it covers the top half of her breast, and sweatpants. Arm sleeves are yanked on and adjusted so that there isn't an exposed sliver of skin between her shirt sleeves and the removable ones. Many years ago, when Vera was a brazen young woman, she never checked her arm sleeves and often walked around with a tanned strip of skin around her upper arms. Those were obviously the wild days when she lived life on the edge and took unnecessary risks. Sleeves on, Vera nods at her reflection and marches to the kitchen, where she gulps down a pint of room temperature water. Cold water, Vera believes, would freeze the fats in your arteries and give you heart disease. At the door, Vera dons her orthopedic sneakers and her tortoiseshell sunglasses, and finally, the last and perhaps most vital article of clothing, a visor so enormous that there is no way that a single ray of freckle-causing, wrinkle-making sunlight could snake its way onto her face. Then, without a backward glance, Vera strides out into the world. And all of this happens without the aid of alarm clocks. Vera should really have been a rooster, but she isn't. She is a pig, and perhaps that is where all the trouble began. According to the Chinese horoscope, pigs are diligent and compassionate and are the ones to call upon when sincere advice is needed. Unfortunately, very few people call Vera for sincere advice or even insincere advice. The one person who should be calling her at all times for advice, her son, Tilbert, never does. Vera doesn't quite understand why. When her parents were alive, she often went to them for advice, even when she didn't need to. Because, unlike her son, Vera was a filial child and knew that asking her parents for advice made them feel needed. Well, no matter. Vera is a diligent mother and goes out of her way to give Tilly all the advice he could ever need anyway. Her previous texts are as follows. Sent today at 4:31 a.m. Tilly, are you awake? It is 4:31 a.m., very late. When I was your age, I wake up at 4 a.m. every morning to cook breakfast for our gong and our ma. Tilly, seize the day. Carpe diem. Kind regards, Mama. Sent yesterday at 7:45 p.m. Tilly, I noticed that this girl, at not Chloe Bennett, has liked two of your videos on the TikTok. I think this means she likes you. I look at her profile and she pout a lot, but I think she will make good wife. She went with her mother for manicure last week. This means she is a filial daughter. Perhaps you should slip and slide into her DM. Kind regards, Mama. Vera had been particularly pleased about using the phrase slip and slide into her DM. Vera insists on keeping up to date with every trend. She doesn't believe in getting left behind by the younger generations. Every time she comes across a nonsensical-sounding phrase, she looks it up on the Google and jots down its meaning in her little notebook. Sent yesterday at 5:01 p.m. Tilly, it is 5 p.m. I hope you have eaten your dinner. Your Uncle Lin eat dinner at 7 p.m. every night, and he didn't even live past 30. You better eat dinner now. Kind regards, Mama. This one actually garnered a reply. Tilly. Uncle Lin died because he was hit by a bus, and I've told you to stop calling me Tilly. I go by Bert. Vera. Don't talk back to your elders. I raise you better than that. And what is wrong with Tilly? It's a good name. Your papa and I think long and hard about your name. You should treasure it. This was followed by more silence from Tilly. But no matter. There is no time for her wayward son right now, because Vera is about to start her morning walk, and morning walks are a serious business. First, there is the stretching. Many people her age complain of stiff joints and unbending limbs, but Vera goes into a low squat without much difficulty and bends at the waist until the tips of her fingers touch her sneakers. When he was a teen, Tilly had been extremely embarrassed about Vera's stretching routine. He'd begged her to do it in the privacy of their home instead of on the sidewalk, but one needs fresh air to properly stretch. And anyway, Tilly should be proud that his mother is setting such a good example for their neighbors. With her muscles sufficiently warmed up, Vera gets into walking position, chin up, chest out, and elbows perpendicular to her body. Then she begins to walk, her fists swinging in front of her chest with the enthusiasm of a North Korean soldier at a national parade. Vera's morning walk can only be described as vigorous. She is a general on the warpath, eating up the miles with ruthless efficiency. Anyone foolish enough to get in her way is met with a cutting glare, which is invisible behind the sunglasses and the visor. But Vera relishes having to swerve around passersby, as it is a chance for her to put her agility and quick reflexes to the test. For her last birthday, Tilly gave her a Samsung watch that could measure her steps, but Vera sees no need for it because she knows exactly how many steps her daily route takes. 3,112 steps, starting on Trenton and Pacific, where her house is, down along Washington, where all the mom-and-pop grocery stores and souvenir shops are preparing to open for the day. Some of the shop owners wave at Vera and call out greetings, but they all know she can't stop for a chat, not when she's on her morning walk. Still, Vera has impeccable manners, so she calls out niceties in Mandarin like, "Wow, the melons look good, Mr. Hong," or "The weather is finally warming up, Sister Zhao," as she zips past. She slows down a little in front of the cafe that sprouted like a particularly pustulant pimple 2 years ago on Washington. The owner is a rude millennial who doesn't even live in Chinatown. Vera's mouth twists in a sneer as she walks past, and as she always does every morning, she places a silent curse on the cafe. Even its name irks her. The cafe. She can just imagine the kind of confusion it has caused to its customers. Where would you like to go? The cafe. Right, which one? The cafe. Which one? You'd think that with a name like that, the cafe would have folded long ago. But no, in defiance of all logic, not only did it not go under, it flourished, stealing customers from the older shops in the vicinity. Often, when Vera sits in her quiet tea shop, her mind wanders to the cafe, and it ruins her perfectly wonderful tea. Truly, the cafe and its horribly unhealthy product, coffee, ugh, are a blight on San Franciscans, nay, on humanity. When she gets down to the Dragon Gate of Chinatown on Bush Street, she turns the corner and walks along Stockton all the way to Wolheyuan, where the Tai Chi Chuan group is just starting their routine. Her husband, Jin Long, came here every day up until he had a stroke. He often tried to get Vera to join him, but Vera did not see the point in Tai Chi. Too slow to do much.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.